show that the sequence an defined by an is equals to 1 by n plus 1 plus 1 by n plus 2 plus 1 by n plus 3 so on plus 1 by n plus n converges. To show the given sequence is convergent, we know that every monotonically increasing sequence which is bounded above converges. Therefore, using this result, we will show that the given sequence is convergent. So, first we will show that the given sequence is monotonically increasing. How we show that the given sequence is monotonically increasing? We know that a sequence is said to be monotonically increasing if an plus 1 is greater than or equals to an for all n belong to n. So first, since we are given an, we will find an plus 1, then we find the difference of an plus 1 and an, then we will show that the difference is positive. Now, we are given that an is 1 by n plus 1 plus 1 by n plus 2 plus 1 by n plus 3 so on 1 by n plus n. Look at this, I written in blue color. The blue color stands, that's a variable, whereas this n is constant. So in an, the numerator 1 is constant. The denominator, the first term n is constant, whereas the second term varies. That is 1, 2, 3, n minus 1, so on, n. Then how do you write an plus 1? Just replace n by n plus 1 in the second term. Not the first term, not the first term. Only in the second term you have to replace. Therefore, we will get, when you replace this n by n plus 1, what do you get? We get n plus 1. Therefore, the next step will be 1 by 2n plus 1. Thus, an plus 1 is equals to 1 by n plus 1 plus 1 by n plus 2, so on. 1 by n plus n plus 1 by 2n plus 1. Now, what do you have to do? We have to find the difference. An plus 1 and an. What's the difference? It is very clear that an starts with 1 by n plus 1 and the last term is 1 by n plus n. Whereas an plus 1 starts with 1 by n plus 1 and ends with 1 by 2n plus 1. What is the last but one term? It is nothing but 1 by n plus n. That is the whole term except the last term, this is nothing but an. And hence the difference will be now an plus 1 minus an is 1 by 2n plus 1. What is 1 by 2n plus 1? 2n is positive. So 2n is positive. 2n plus 1 is positive. Therefore, 1 by 2n plus 1 is positive and hence this an plus 1 minus an is greater than 0 for all n. That is, an plus 1 is greater than an for all n belong to n. That means the sequence an is monotonically increasing. Now the second case is, we have to show that it is bounded above. For this again consider an. What is an? An is 1 by n plus 1 plus 1 by n plus 2 plus 1 by n plus 3 so on. 1 by n plus n. Now look at the case here. We know that modulus of x plus y is less than or equals to mod x plus mod y. That is a triangular inequality. Now using this triangular inequality, we are going to show that this sequence an is bounded above. Now taking modulus on both sides, therefore modulus of an is equal to modulus of all the terms of an, that is 1 by n plus 1, 1 by n plus 2 plus so on plus 1 by n plus n. Now we will apply triangular inequality. When we apply the triangular inequality, what happens? Equal becomes inequality, because modulus of x plus y is less than or equals to mod x plus mod y. Therefore, modulus of this each and every term will be less than or equals to modulus of every term, that is less than or equal to modulus of 1 by n plus 1 plus modulus of 1 by n plus 2 plus modulus of so on plus modulus of 1 by n plus n. We know that 4 is greater than 3, right? It's reciprocal. What happened? 1 by 4 less than 1 by 3, which is greater? 1 by 3 is greater than 1 by 4. Now put n equal to 3, then what happened here? 1 by 3 becomes 1 by n. Then what about 4? 3 plus 1, 4. That is 1 by n plus 1 is less than 1 by n. What is 1 by n plus 2? Less than 1 by n. What is 1 by n plus 3? Less than 1 by n. What is 1 by n plus n? Less than n. That is each and every term here, each and every term here is strictly less than modulus of 1 by n. What is n? N is a natural number. Therefore, we need not write modulus. We need not write modulus. And hence, we can remove the modulus. Therefore, it is 1 by n plus 1 by n plus 1 by n plus 1 by n. How many terms are there? There are n terms. See here? An. Start with 1, 2, 3. What's the last number? N. Therefore, there are n terms. And hence, this is equals to, there are n 1 by n's. Therefore, n into 1 by n equals to 1. That is, modulus of an less than 1. It is true for all n. Therefore, modulus of an is less than 1 for all n. N belong to natural number. Thus implies an is bounded. Thus, the sequence an is monotonically increasing. Now it is bounded above. Hence, it converges. See, a very simple one, very easy one. By taking the difference between an plus 1 and an, we have shown that it is monotonically increasing. By taking modulus of an and using triangular inequality, also we are used 1 by n plus 1 is less than 1 by n. We are shown that which is bounded above by 1. Therefore, the given sequence is monotonically increasing and bounded above by 1, and hence it is convergent. Let us consider another example. Show that the sequence an defined by an is equal to 1 plus 1 by 1 factorial plus 1 by 2 factorial plus 1 by 3 factorial plus so on 1 by n factorial converges. Here, let us first show that this sequence is bounded above. Then we show that which is monotonically increasing. Then we can conclude that it is a convergent sequence. Now consider what is given here. We are given an is equals to 1 plus 1 by 1 factorial. Remember that 1 by 1 factorial is also 1 by 1 equal to 1. Plus 1 by 2 factorial plus 1 by 3 factorial, so on 1 by n factorial. Now we are going to show that this sequence is
bounded above.
That can be proved using mathematical induction. So let us take, what is A1? A1 is 1 plus 1 by 1 factorial, n equal to 1, n equal to 1. So 1 by n factorial becomes 1 by 1 factorial. So 1 plus 1 by 1 factorial, 1 plus 1 is equal to 2. We know that, we want to show that something is bounded above. What do you want to prove? An, modulus of an is less than some real number for all n belong to n. Therefore, we know that 3 is greater than 2. And hence, A1 is less than 3. A1 is less than 3. Now, we will show that An is also less than 3. The value of the whole An is also less than 3. Now, what is An? 1 plus 1 by 1 factorial plus 1 by 2 factorial plus 1 by 3 factorial, so on 1 by n factorial. As we consider one case in the previous problem, that is 1 by n plus 1 is less than 1 by n. The same way we are going to consider one result here. We know that 1 by 3 factorial is 6, right? 1 by 3 factorial is equal to 1 by 6 because 3 factorial is 6. 6 is less than 1 by 4. 1 by 4 can be written as 1 by 2 square. Therefore, 1 by 3 factorial is strictly less than 1 by 2 square. 1 by 2 square. See, 1 by 3 factorial is strictly less than 1 by 2 square. In the same way, we can show that 1 by 4 factorial is less than 1 by 2 power 3. 1 by 5 factorial is strictly less than 1 by 2 power 4. Therefore, 1 by n factorial will be strictly less than 1 by 2 to the power n. Why n minus 1? If the number is 3 here, we get 2. If the number is 4 here, we get 3. Therefore, whenever is n is here, 1 by n factorial is less than 1 by 2 to the power n minus 1. Therefore, this an can be rewritten as less than. Why less than? When you take this equal, so equal to 1 plus 1 by 1 factorial, so 1. But when you come to 1 by 2 factorial, what is 1 by 2 factorial? Is equals to 1 by 2. Come here. When it comes to 1 by 3 factorial, what happens? There is no equality. There is no equality. Up to first three terms, you are equal, same thing written. There is no change in it. When you come to fourth term, namely 1 by 3 factorial, what happened? 1 by 3 factorial is less than 1 by 2 square. Therefore, now it becomes less than symbol. So, 1 by 2 square, so 1 plus, when you come to nth term, plus 1 by 2 to the power n. Yeah. Now look at this inequality. Except the first term, consider the rest of n terms. They are 1 plus 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2 square plus 1 by 2 cube, so on, plus 1 by 2 to the power n minus 1. What is this sum? This sum is nothing but sum of first n terms of a geometric progression with the first term is 1, that is A equals to 1. Then what is the common ratio? The common ratio is second term divided by first term, that is 1 by 2 divided by 1 is 1 by 2. Therefore, the term next term is model an is less than 1 except the first term, plus the rest of the terms are nothing but a geometric progression. So in a geometric progression, the sum of first n term is a into 1 minus r to the power n by 1 minus r, where a is the first term is 1 and the common ratio is second term divided by first term is 1 by 2. Therefore, this can be written as an is less than 1 plus. What is this geometric progression? The sum of geometric progression. A is 1. 1 minus r. R is 1 by 2 whole power n. Divided by 1 minus r. That is 1 minus 1 by 2. That is equals to 1 plus 2 into, so if we simplify this, what happened? The denominator, it is 1 minus 1 by 2. So it is nothing but 1 by 2. So 2 comes up, that is a 1. That is equals into 1 minus 1 by 2 to the power n. That is equals to, now multiply 1 plus multiply by 2, we get 2 minus 2 by 2 power n. That is equals to 1 plus 2, that is 3, minus 2 divided by 2 power n, that is nothing but minus 1 by 2 to the power n minus 1, which is less than 3, because this is 3, this is a positive value. So 3 minus some small value, which will be always less than 3. Thus, we have shown that a1 is less than 3, an is also less than 3. Now we are going to show that an plus 1 is also less than 3. What is an plus 1? 1 plus 1 by 1 factorial plus 1 by 2 factorial, so on. In the place of n, we are going to write n plus 1. Therefore, here the last term is n plus 1 factorial. Like the previous case, as we discussed the case of an, 1 by 3 factorial is less than 1 by 2 square. Similarly, here the above equation can be written as an plus 1 is equals to 1 plus 1 by 1 factorial plus 1 by 2 factorial is 2. That is the first three terms. So an plus 1 equals to the first three terms. When it comes to the fourth term, that is 1 by 3 factorial. What is 1 by 3 factorial? 1 by 3 factorial is less than 1 by 2 square. Therefore, when it comes to the fourth term, we have to write less than symbol. Therefore, an plus 1 is 1 less than 1 plus 1 plus 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2 square. So, 1 by n factorial is less than 1 by 2 to the power n minus 1 plus 1 by n plus 1 factorial is less than 1 by 2 to the power n. Again, if we consider the first n plus, except the first term, 1 plus 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2 square, so on, plus 1 by 2 to the power n, it is again a geometric progression. That is sum of first n plus 1 terms of a GP. So, that is equal to 3 minus 1 by 2 power n as above. Here it is 2 power n minus 1, 2 power n, therefore it is 2 power n minus 1, whereas here we have a n plus 1, that is n, therefore we have to write 1 by 2 power n, therefore even then, which is less than 3 as above. Thus we have shown that an plus 1 3, an is less than 3. Now an plus 1 is also less than 3. Hence, by mathematical induction, an is less than 3 for all n belong to n. Therefore, an is bounded above by 3. Now, we have to show that an is increasing sequence. For that, we have to find the difference between an plus 1 and an. What is an plus 1? It starts from 1 to 1 by n plus 1 factorial. That is 1 plus 1 by 1 factorial plus 1 by n plus 1 factorial plus 1 by n plus 1 factorial. What is an? An is 1 plus 1 by 1 factorial plus 1 by 2 factorial. So, 1 plus 1 by n factorial. Remember that an plus 1 has only one term more than an. What is the term? The term is 1 by n plus 1 factorial. Therefore, if you find the difference, an plus 1 minus an, what do we get? We simply see first n plus 1 term can cancel. We will be left with 1 by n plus 1 factorial. That is an plus 1 minus an is equal to 1 by n plus 1 factorial, which is greater than 0. Therefore, an plus 1 is greater than an for all n. Hence, we will get an is monotonically increasing. Thus, here it is bounded above, here it is monotonically increasing, and as we know that a sequence which is monotonically increasing and bounded above